The Education of a Value Investor by Guy Spier. What's the best way to spend $650,000? Purchase your dream car? Buy a new house? A luxurious vacation you always wanted to go? How about lunch with Warren Buffett? Well, lunch with Warren Buffett was what Guy Spier chose to do. Well, to be fair, that money went to charity and he shared the cost with another investor, Mohesh Pabrai. But still, $650,000 is a ton of money for a lunch appointment, no matter how you cut it. Well, Warren Buffett helped alter the course of Guy Spier's life and made him a lot of money. And today, Guy Spier manages the Aquamarine Fund, which has made him and his co-investors very rich. In today's video, I will dive into the key factors that helped Spier become a successful investor so that you too can be someday pay $650,000 to a successful investor for lunch. Before I go on to talk more about the five takeaways from the book, The Education of a Value Investor by Guy Spier, I would appreciate it if you could take 3 seconds of your time to like this video and subscribe to this YouTube channel. I create many educational videos to help you become a better investor and trader. I also have a 3-day trading guide which you can download via the link in the description below. Takeaway number one, invest in a mentor at all costs. Despite having a great educational background, Spier still felt clueless about his direction when he first started his career. Unlike school, which gives you materials and assignments to guide you along the way, Spier did not have a guide to tell him which way to go. According to Spier, having a mentor who is able to tell you which direction to go is a major thing that helps accelerate the process of achieving the goal you set. As an investment banker, Spier came to learn about Warren Buffett and his methods of value investing. This discovery altered Spier's life for the better. After studying Buffett's books, annual reports, and the companies that Buffett chooses to invest in, he started to think more like Buffett. Often, when evaluating a company, he will ask himself, what would Buffett do in his shoes? And herein lies the first takeaway. Individuals who keep on studying from people who are more accomplished will advance much faster. You don't necessarily have to meet the person face to face, as there is a tremendous amount of wisdom that can be found in books or even on the internet. You simply need to put in the work to get hold of it. Find a mentor that can lead you along the path that they have already walked and mimic their actions. Takeaway number two, staying away from debt. Making a fortune in the stock market requires you to be rational, even when the general public is driven by fear or greed. And one of the many things that inhibit your ability to think clearly is debt. When you are in debt, you can no longer think clearly as you are driven by the need to make money to pay off the debt. It deteriorates your thinking process when you need it the most and might cause you to make mistakes. Furthermore, each mistake that you made becomes more expensive with debt since you are required to pay interest on the debt. It is often said that you should buy when there's blood in the streets. But what happens if your portfolio is already wiped out when it's time to start buying? On the 15th of September 2008, Spier was sitting on his desk watching one of the major investment banks, Lehman Brothers, file for bankruptcy. His entire family's net worth was at risk, along with those who had invested their savings with him. Somehow, he remained calm and managed to get out of the crisis. But I would like you to consider what would have happened if he had leveraged and borrowed money to invest. He certainly would have been wiped out and probably give up his career in investing. So the point here is not to use leverage, because you don't need huge amount of capital in the stock market if you know what you are doing. Takeaway number three, be careful with what information you consume. With the rise of social media and false news circulating, it is so easy to get distracted and confused between what is factual and what is an opinion. One of Spier's bold moves was moving to Switzerland with his family. Talk about his commitment to investing and being at the top of his game. He moved to Switzerland with his family to set up an office near Zurich just to avoid Wall Street. Now, I'm not saying that you need to make such a bold move, but the point is that you need to be very careful with what information you consume. Is CNN actually helping you find excellent stocks? Or is it simply convincing you of the next latest hot stock that is likely to grow tenfold in a short period of time? These are questions that you have to ask yourself honestly and take the appropriate action. Consider Buffett's daily routine, where he consumes information from newspapers, annual reports, and trade press. He's known for spending about 80% of his day just reading and trying to get first-hand information. Being careful to discern between facts and opinions. Takeaway number 4. The market is designed to get you to be active. The financial rewards for investing goes to the inactive, not the active. This is a very important takeaway that can never be overemphasized. Wall Street and brokerages are rewarded based on activity. The more you trade, the more they make in terms of commissions. Common retail stock investors such as you and I are rewarded for inactivity. Charlie Munger, the right-hand man of Warren Buffett, coins it, "Sit on your ass investing." The stock market should be viewed as a shopping center that you visit every once in a while for the purpose of reallocation. As an investor, you are selecting stocks that you believe will outperform the general market. There is no need to spend time observing the constant fluctuations in price, getting excited when your investment rises in value, and getting worried when your investment falls in value. Focus instead on your stock picking process, the thing that actually determines how much money you make. Here's a great rule that Spear advocates. Don't trade while the market's open. Instead, wait for the market to close and then do your adjustments the following day. This rule will do wonders for you as you keep your emotions at a safe distance and help you to make rational decisions. If you ever skip an investment just because the price went a little higher than what you anticipated to pay, that's a sign that you are not really investing, since there isn't a large margin of safety, a concept that Warren Buffett advocates. Instead, you want to follow the fundamentals of the companies that you are interested in, while occasionally checking for discrepancies between the price of the company and value. Takeaway number 5. Never talk about your investments. Spears recommends not talking about your investment. While this might sound like a really small thing, this advice is meant to help you optimize your investment process and prevent any unnecessary inputs. As you share your investments with others, debates might arise which may alter your investment decisions. You also have an easier time changing your opinions as the fundamentals of the companies unfold, since it is much more difficult to change your opinion after you have told others about it and convinced yourself. And that's my top 5 takeaways from the book, The Education of a Value Investor by Spear. Here's a quick recap of the takeaways. Invest in a mentor. It will accelerate your progress tremendously. You want to avoid debt and leveraging when investing because it can get you into a lot of trouble. When investing, you need to be very careful with the information that you are consuming, being sure to discern between facts and opinions. You also want to avoid staying at price fluctuations all day, trade actively, or talk about your investments. Hopefully you found value from this video. As always, if you benefited from this video, please make sure to subscribe to this channel. Click the notification icon so you won't miss any of my new videos. Do leave me a like to support this channel. Thanks for watching, and make sure you download the free day trading guide via the link in the description below.